China, a land of towering mountains, fertile plains, and a rich tapestry of history. Fractured by war, 6th century China witnessed the rise of a powerful emperor in the north. This is the story of Emperor Wu of the Northern Zhou dynasty, a man who united the region through military might and bold reforms. Born in 543 AD, this future emperor was given the Shanbei name, Miluotu. The Shanbei were a formidable nomadic people who thrived on the vast Mongolian plateau. Renowned for their horsemanship and fierce military prowess, they played a pivotal role in shaping the course of Chinese history. In 560, at the young age of 17, Miluotu ascended to the throne as Emperor Wu of the Northern Zhou dynasty. His key achievement was military. He built a strong army and unified Northern China by conquering the rival Northern Qi dynasty in 577. But Emperor Wu was not just a military leader. He was a shrewd strategist and a reformer. He tackled social and political issues, streamlining the government and promoting meritocratic selection of officials. His policies, though often brutal, laid the groundwork for a more stable and efficient administration. Despite his accomplishments, Emperor Wu's reign was tragically short-lived. He died in 578 at the young age of 36. Though his reign was short, it had a lasting impact. He laid the groundwork for the subsequent Sui dynasty, which would finally reunify all of China. His genetic profile and physical characteristics, including his appearance and potential diseases, have garnered significant interest from the academic community and the public. DNA analysis conducted in 2024 revealed that Emperor Wu's ancestry was more complex than previously thought. Emperor Wu derived 61% of his ancestry from ancient Northeast Asians and nearly one-third from Yellow River farmers, a group associated with the Han Chinese. This can likely be attributed to continuous intermarriage between Shanbei royal families and local Han Chinese aristocrats. The remaining 6% of his ancestry is thought to have come from Western steppe herders. Overall, his genetic profile most closely resembles that of Northeast Asians. He shared the closest genetic relationship with an ancient Khitan sample, as well as modern Mongolian populations and Tungusic-speaking Orochun and Hojon people. Emperor Wu's Y chromosome haplogroup is CFGC28912, a subclade of CF1756, which is a dominant lineage among the Shanbei people. His mitochondrial DNA haplogroup is C401. Both his paternal and maternal lineages can be traced back to Northeast Asia, where they are still found at low to moderate frequencies. By combining genetic data with cutting-edge facial reconstruction techniques, scientists were able to create a possible likeness of Emperor Wu. The result shows he had brown eyes, black hair, and dark to intermediate skin color, and his facial features were similar to those of present-day North and East Asians. The DNA provides new clues not only about his appearance but also about the cause of his death at the young age of 36. While historical records suggest he died of either illness or poisoning, genetic analysis suggests a stroke may have been the culprit. This is consistent with historical accounts that he suffered from aphasia, drooping eyelids, and an abnormal gait, all of which are potential symptoms of a stroke. By delving into Emperor Wu's DNA, we gain a deeper understanding of this powerful leader and the vibrant history of the Northern Zhou dynasty. His story serves as a reminder that ethnicity is a fluid concept, shaped by the currents of history and the winds of cultural exchange.
Thank you.